Right, I'm excited for everyone to meet our next guest, the fantastic actor and director, Linas Phillips. But first, let's take a look at the trailer for a great indie film he co-starred in last year. It's streaming on Netflix. Brian loves it. It's called Manson Family Vacation. Just so you know, Linas is the one with the beard and the interesting obsession. Take a look.
Pat McGroin called?
Pat McGroin? This is my brother. He's playing a joke on you.
I didn't know you had a brother.
I don't know what he's doing here. I don't know where we're going to put him.
I just thought I'd camp out there.
You're gonna camp in the backyard? There's no consideration for anybody else.
What are you doing in my yard?
It's mine.
You're gonna love this, but I actually quit my job.
That makes me feel so much better that you've quit your job.
Yeah,
no, it's not irresponsible. This is a time in your life where you're supposed to be untethering yourself. You know, when you're 40, you gotta break free.
I have something for us to do.
Okay.
Well, you know Charles Manson?
Yeah, I know who Charles Manson is.
Well, there are these sites all around the city. I have it all mapped out.
Hello.
Oh, my God.
This guy's gonna call the cops. He's always been into stuff like this, like anything with death in it.
What's this?
Helter Skelter.
Why would he get off on something like that?
Because he's messed up in the head? What are you guys talking about?
There's some really cool pictures of dead people.
This is the same booth that they ate at, Sharon Tate and her friends, that same night they went home.
Got it.
This is where they wrote on the fridge in blood, Helter Skelter.
Hey, is that a Charlie Manson t-shirt?
Ah! Abort!
I'm sensing some tension.
You do not have a driver's license.
No, are you gonna give me a big lecture?
Do not resist me.
Does that feel good? Don't grab me, you pig.
Stop talking.
Hello, y'all.
Welcome to the group.
What the hell is going on? Are you not telling me something?
The group, they have a slight association with Charlie.
Charlie's on the phone.
Dude, I gotta go.
I'm gonna put him on.
Yeah.
He's right here.
Do not pick it up. Do not pick that phone up.
Hello?
I bring up Charles Manson and you freak out. Everybody freaks out when you bring up Charles Manson.
The movie's great. That wannabe Manson groupie is here with us now. Remember, folks, that was just
what
a movie.
Wannabe?
Last month at South by Southwest, Linas Phillips also screened his latest film as writer, director, and star. It's called Rainbow Time. We'll hear about that and everything else he's up to. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome Linas Phillips to BK Live. Linas, thank you so much for being here. How are you doing?
Good.
Let us gaze upon you. This has to be the definitive Linas Phillips interview. We really are. How did you get involved in that movie, Manson Family Vacation?
Well, the director, Jay Davis, not Jay Duplass, he knew both of us. He's a filmmaker, a writer, and he wrote this script with me and Jay in mind, and it was just kind of us nurturing it along for like 2 years, really. And Jay hadn't even done Transparent yet, so he wasn't even, it was kind of an odd choice to try to cast the other Duplass brother.
Right, had he acted before that movie?
I mean,
who knows?
Mainly on the Mindy project in like a commercial sense, he's like, I don't know, I mean, he's sort of felt like, I mean, he was always just the one holding the camera. That's why he was never in their early work. And it was just like, I know how to work a camera, so Mark, you're in the movie. But anyway, so Jay Davis wrote this with us in mind. And it was cool just to like, it was very collaborative and just we worked on it like this little passion hobby art project on the side. And then finally I was like, oh, we're actually gonna shoot it, okay. And we went down and, yeah.
It's so good. You're great in it.
Thank you.
I mean, you mentioned Jay and Mark Duplass. These are very successful, I'd say, film producers. What has your experience been like working with them? They worked with you on your new movie, Rainbow Time. What do you learn from them about making independent movies?
From Jay, I learned a lot about just to get it done, you know, like I was working on my Rainbow Time script for years and, you know, I was like, I can't figure this out and I can't make it perfect. He's like, that doesn't have to be perfect. Just set it up, then you get to that scene and that scene's gonna be really good. Don't worry about, or like, and then I had two characters. I'm like, well, I think of this scene, then there's an ex-girlfriend. He's like, I think there's just one girl in the movie, you know, just simplify it. He gave a lot of great encouraging notes like that, and you know,
and like, completing it's better than it being perfect.
Yes.
Okay.
Having a movie that you're proud of and you did your best on is better than like never making the movie because you're too scared of not making it perfect.
That's what we say about BK Live every day. But this is the second time that you guys are going to be playing on screen brothers. I wonder if you like have any siblings at all. What is this brother thing that keeps
coming
back?
Well, if you want Mark and Jay to produce your movie, you have to make it.
Is that true? That makes
sense.
That's
the inside track.
There's the answer.
It's like, we're sick of doing brother movies, but we're contractually obligated.
To have you do one.
Yeah.
I want to know, so I know you as thousands of people did. I first met you when we were both doing comedy in Boston. Mm-hmm. I feel like, I want to ask.
I don't know about thousands of people.
Thousands? No,
dozens of people remember my very small stand-up comedy career between 1998 and 2003.
Well, and of course, yeah.
From that to movie stardom.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. I have had a weird trajectory. I went to acting school, not filmmaking school, but I made short films in high school, and then... Yeah, I went to NYU here and then started doing comedy. One-man shows and stand-up was just like a natural thing, and I loved comedy, so I was like a fan and went to Luna Lounge and all the cool shows that were happening here in New York in like the late 90s, early 2000s.
But and, film was all it was kind of a passion for you?
Yeah, and I guess I had been writing these one-man shows, and sometimes they were like scenes, and actually a friend of we both know was like, why don't you just do like a play or a movie, you know? And I feel like eventually I just kind of got more confident as a writer that I turned it into movies, because my first two movies were documentaries.
Right, let's talk about one of those, Walking
to
Werner.
A different sidetrack.
Yeah, documentary.
Finally, I'm on track.
Let's talk about Walking to Werner. You walked the California coast to meet Werner Herzog.
Yeah.
What can you tell us about that? I mean, do you have a relationship with Werner Herzog?
I'm an idiot. I can tell you. I walked for 2 months because I wanted to make a movie about walking and about my passion. It was like an homage for Werner Herzog, who's gone on lots of long walks. Like, he tried to walk around the border of Germany before the reunification of Germany. He was like, he said, if you want to marry someone, you don't just call them on the phone and propose. You have to walk there. Walk there with the ring burning in your pocket. Anyway, so I was like, okay, I want to move to LA. I was living in Seattle, you know, but I should do it right. This will be the right way to do it, which is, in fact, not moving to LA at all because I was broke and I had to move back to Seattle to finish editing the movie. But I made this movie, which I'm the best thing about it is all these interviews, meeting these like characters on the road, these drifter types. And yeah, it's really some great, amazing stories.
So from Werner to Mr. Lynch, you're working with some phenomenal people. What's he really like?
Mr. Lynch, it was cool. It was like a weird, surreal moment. I was on the phone outside the trailers, and someone came up to me, oh, can you be quiet? David's meditating. And I was like, yes, perfect. That is amazing. That's like the cliche thing that just happened. But anyway, yeah, I did a cameo, a very small part on Twin Peaks. So I did
any spoilers?
Just,
people are crazy.
Yeah, I'll tell you what
show.
Happened.
Can you tell us who killed Laura Palmer?
Look into that camera. Yeah.
I'll tell you all the spoilers. Actually, Donald Trump appears on the show. Can
opposite
tell you that.
Jim Belushi.
Opposite Jim and John Belushi.
Okay. Looking forward to the new Twin Peaks.
No, but Rainbow Time. Tell us about that. What is the crux of the new thing?
Yeah, Rainbow Time is, yeah, like the Manson Family Vacation, about two brothers, but because of contractual obligations. But but anyway,
with the Duplasses.
Yeah. But it's about Shaunzi, this developmentally delayed grown-up.
A character
who I
you've
play.
Performed at live. You performed at, on Stand Up Brooklyn, which is a show we do. Anyway, go on. Shaunzi is the main character.
Yeah, and he's obsessed with Fonzie, which is why his name is Shaunzi. And he's obsessed with bad action movies and his brother's new girlfriend, Lindsay, played by Melanie Lynskey. And
his character's based on Greg Johnson, clearly.
Interesting.
Action movies in the Fonz.
Yeah, bad action movies.
What has been the reception of the movie so far? I mean, is there anything you learn when you watch people watch it versus, you know, the years you take to write it?
People are always surprised that, like, they're like, did anyone kind of bust you that you're playing this developmentally delayed guy? And no one brings that up. I think they really see that the movie is, although funny, it's really just like a heartwarming.
Humanity.
And yeah, I'm trying to, I worked with special needs kids for years here in New York, and as you know, as a babysitter and teacher assistant, and you know, so yeah, it's kind of a love letter to, you know, those kids that I worked with.
Were you inspired when you were working with those kids to kind of maybe make a character and movie based around it eventually, or you know, it just kind of happened more naturally than that?
It was, yeah, just more naturally. Just I had been working on this character off and on for years, and then I kind of like, I think the story element, the effect that it had on the story, like, you know, this taught my Tim Sharp, who plays my brother in the movie, he's had to deal with this older brother who kind of talks down to him, even though he's the one with more issues, and he's trying to be the big brother and give him advice and try to convince him to make a sex tape with his girlfriend to help his relationship.
I can't you know, wait to see it.
So he has to just deal with all this and humor him, and you know, just the frustration you feel having a family member.
Who are you? Do you have siblings?
Like that. Yeah, I have two brothers. So yeah,
there you go. I have two brothers too. That maybe that's why these movies resonate. Speak to me. Yeah, I love them though. Shout out to my brothers, and they love your movies. What's next? What's the next project?
Well, I'm working on a script. I don't know if it'll be a TV show or a movie, but about a guy who's starting his own religion. Yeah,
excellent.
It's like maybe a cult or maybe a religion. You can't. It's like the fine line between helping people and hurting people.
Well, we've got a TV station here. Send us some pages. Mm-hmm. We'll
all right.
Review it.
We'll hook you up.
All right.
I mean, this new movie again, produced by the Duplass brothers. It's great. It's your writing and directing debut. Very much looking forward to Rainbow Time. Love everything else that you do, including your Shanzi on Stand Up Brooklyn, which is on BRIC TV. I don't even know if that aired. It's a little subversive, but it's phenomenal.
The Shanzi doing stand-up is pretty dirty. So.
Yeah, but it's the best, man. Thank you so much for being on BK Live here, Linus. I really appreciate it.
Thank
Looking
you.
Forward to Rainbow Time and Twin Peaks.
And Twin Peaks.